Welcome back, trainers. So we have some pretty exciting information here. If you enjoy these kind of videos, make sure you hit that like button, subscribe if you're new, and I will be keeping you posted on everything Pokemon Go. So we were initially discussing how Giovanni was going to enter into Pokemon Go. I even brought up the theory as to maybe he could possibly be an EX raid boss, which is definitely not going to be the case, but we are going to have something else that may resemble that sort of thing here. As you can see, this pink pass, no, that's not made up. That was actually found within the Pokemon Go's data for the newest update. So this is all very exciting stuff. Now, we also had some more images tweeted out by the official Pokemon Go Twitter page, which we will also be looking at, hinting towards some new possible Team Rocket raid bosses, or bosses in general, stronger grunts, maybe even bodyguards for Giovanni possibly. What are those images? Well, if you haven't seen Twitter, this is what they look like here. So we have a female to the left and some sort of bodyguard builder guy in the middle. And then, which looks, the first image they put out, the one all the way to the right, did look like a possible male. But with this clear image here, I'm pretty sure it's going to be a female of some sort. So very interesting stuff here. This is what I was wanting to see all along. Stronger grunts, some sort of significance to their meaning, and an actual challenge. So that pass, what does it even mean? Well, if you're watching my previous videos, we did go over some information that was found by data miners regarding some sort of ticketed event. Now, it doesn't say whether or not you're going to actually have to purchase this, or if it's going to be distributed a certain way, possibly if you do a certain amount of Team Rocket stops, right? Who knows if it's just going to be distributed randomly. Maybe you might have to purchase it or claim it, and a certain amount of people can go to it. Although it's going to be in-game wherever you are, so it shouldn't really make too much of a difference. Now, taking a look at this new loading screen, this is very significant to the whole picture of what we're trying to see here. So this is basically grunts, and then in the very back there, which we're going to take a closer look at, obviously is going to be Giovanni, you know, surrounded by those bodybuilder, the one to the left, and then the other grunts that we did see there. The one with the glasses, I do believe, is the one with the bun to the right of Arcanine, which looked like she's wearing a bigger kind of poofier jacket. So we will be seeing those new grunts entering in, and then as well as that Giovanni in the back there, surrounded by all of these shadow Pokemon. So what is it even going to be? Well, we were wondering how we're going to actually battle, you know, Giovanni. Is he going to take over a raid? Is he going to be in the Pokestop but actually be difficult with six Pokemon? Well, I think we found the answer. And that is going to be, he's going to have his own Coliseum of sorts. And we're also going to be going into more details as to how this is going to be very significant for Pokemon Go's future. Now, I did make a video a long time ago discussing this very thing. And I'm not saying I came up with this or anything, but it's just funny how we did go over this in the past, going over how we can, you know, it'd be nice to have some sort of gym leaders in the raids. We have to beat them, get a possible badge, get all the badges, and then work our way up to the Elite Four, battle them, and then become champion, and then get a ticket to go to a tournament with other trainers. I'm very excited to see Giovanni in Pokemon Go, and I've been waiting for some sort of event, kind of like this that we're seeing unfold before us here. And with all this evidence pouring towards it, it's just a matter of time before we're going to see other possible gym leaders or other corrupted members in the Pokemon world being bosses here. And Giovanni is going to be a magnificent entrance for all of this, I do believe. As you saw, that previous data mine information going over that pass, and now we actually have a visual image here. I will leave a link to this data miner's Twitter in the description so you can go and check him out and follow him yourself. So let's go ahead and see what we have here. A ticket Coliseum discovery. A ticket to access a Coliseum discovery special event on November 2nd. 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. your local time, wherever you are. So like we just went over, who knows where this is actually going to take place. If you use this pass and it's just going to have a tent that pops up right in front of you. it would be whatever if that was the case. I would much more enjoy going to a specific area. And I'm not talking about traveling really far. I'm talking about maybe the closest gym or something like that. You input this pass and it all of a sudden transforms for you into some sort of Coliseum in which you're going to have to battle Giovanni. But first you have to go through the trials and take out his bodyguards, which are actually going to be very difficult, not like your average grunt. I think we're being trained right now, going up against these grunts, some of them easy, some of them a little bit more difficult if you did not pick the right types. So this is amazing stuff. Pokemon Go is in full swing. This is it. This is what they needed. All they need to do now is fix the bugs, right? Now, I hope they don't release this and it's littered with all kinds of errors and things like that, because that would just ruin the whole experience. But let's not get too much on the negative here. So, Giovanni, this pass, I'm pretty sure that's what it's all linked to. And before we know it, Giovanni is going to, I don't know how long they're going to keep him in this Coliseum, if it's actually going to be Giovanni, but it is paving the road for the future for us to actually battle gym leaders like we've went over many times. Very exciting stuff here. Could you imagine if we can actually earn badges in Pokemon Go? It is going to be nice. You can go into your trophies, see your badges. Maybe you have to battle a specific gym leader so many times, kind of like taking over a gym and holding it. You eventually get it gold. Maybe we'll have all the badges in there and we have to kind of bring them up for a specific time, and then we'll have them gold and something will unlock for us. So it is only a matter of time before possibly, just maybe, we might see other gym leaders for Pokemon Go revolving around this Coliseum. This is opening up so many doors for the world of Pokemon Go, as a matter of fact, and not just raiding, catching Pokemon, lucky trades and all. You know, all these features that they're implementing are great, and they're just laying the groundwork for a solid game. But like we've already been over, and I'm not going to focus too much on the negative, but they really do need to work out a lot of the bugs in this game. Sometimes I'm sitting there wondering to myself, what am I still doing? This game is super buggy and I'm still playing it. Obviously, I'm not going to just stop, but this is great, guys. This is very exciting. So let's get hyped for this. Now, let's go ahead and take a look at my recent catches here. I did get a shiny Seviper right before the event did end, lucky me. And then I did go ahead and do a mirror trade with Scarlet just for the heck of it to see what would happen. And it didn't go lucky or nothing, because we still haven't become lucky friends. We are literally on the top of each other's friends list and not lucky. And I did go plus this one this morning as well. Oh, and by the way, the Seviper's IVs that she did trade to me got better, so that's good. The one I originally caught was horrible. I did also go plus this Barbaroach yesterday. Unfortunately, if I do evolve it, it's going to be about 15 points above the Great League. And then I did, in fact, go plus my first shiny Swablu that I personally caught myself, which is pretty nice. And then this magnificent Weavile, which Scarlet Witch yet again gave me a shiny. It was a Sneasel originally, and I did evolve it. It's going to cost almost 300,000 stardust to max that one out. Her attack is actually pretty good. And then I did do a lucky Yanmega trade and receive a very decent IV Yanmega there, which I did evolve. Now let's go ahead and look at my Giratina encounters here, because guys, I'm up to about a lot. Over 80 raids, let's just say that. And I still haven't found a shiny. The RNG gods do not like me. And as a matter of fact, I have a new name for the RNG, and it's not really random number generator. It's selected number generator, because it's to my belief that it is not random all the way, because some of these lower accounts are just getting them. No discredit to anybody out there. I even had a friend who traded me that Shadow Ball Haunter. He did 3 Mewtwo raids and got 2 shinies. He also did 3 Giratina raids and got 1 shiny. That's absolutely incredible. And he doesn't really play that much, so it's kind of credit to the whole discussion we were having in that other video. Now, also, we're going to be having quite a few legendary raid hours. These are going to be taking place October 2nd, October 9th, and 16th for the altered form Giratina. Also, take note that we are going to be getting a new EX raid boss. I don't know exactly the dates for those, and people are thinking it might be Darkrai, but we also have more raid hours on October 3rd and 30th taking place then, so they're to be announced. Could that possibly be Giratina Origin Form? I think it might be that. It's going to be about that time around the month. They might just release that one as well as its shiny variants, and you'll be able to catch it then. Are they going to possibly release Darkrai publicly for the raids? Maybe, guys. I don't know quite yet if they're going to just release a mythical just like that, throw it out there into the raids. Yes, Deoxys was public, but let's think about it. It was also in the EX raids for a year. One excruciating year of Deoxys over and over again, which was a mythical. It was fun at first, but the fun slowly wore out. So anyways, hope you enjoy this video. Take note of all this stuff. Giovanni is coming into Pokemon Go very soon, and that just might bring a whole new world with it. Thank you for watching, trainers, and I'll be catching you all next time. Take care.